Hey guys, this is the second part of the Roanoke Colony 1 Minute History. So after the first colony was abandoned, Sir Walter Raleigh is persuaded to try again. He agrees in 1587, send John White, making him the governor of the new colony. A second set of colonists, which include John White's pregnant daughter, Eleanor Dare, are sent with White. Raleigh had planned on them going to Chesapeake Bay area. However, Simon Fernandez, a Portuguese navigator, drops them off at Roanoke and refuses to let them back on board. So the settlers end up repairing the remains of the first colony structures. While there, John White becomes friends with a tribe of Native Americans who tell him that a different tribe had previously killed some of the members from the first Roanoke colony. White sets off to attack the tribe one early morning, but finds out too late that it is a friendly tribe and not the people he thought they were. From there, relations with the natives went downhill. Meanwhile, his daughter gives birth to a girl, who they name Virginia, because she is the first Christian born in the Virginia colony. White is forced to go back to England because they didn't have enough supplies. He is delayed by the Anglo-Spanish War, and he doesn't come back for another 3 years. When he returns, the settlement is abandoned, and the only clue is the word Croatoan carved into a wooden wall. White wasn't able to go to the next island where the Croatoan Indians lived, and where he believed the settlers had gone. Bad seas kept him from getting there, and his men refused to go any further. He had told the settlers to put a cross on a nearby tree if anything bad were to happen to them, but there was no cross, so he assumed they ended up on the island. John Wright never sees his daughter or granddaughter again. To this day, no one knows what happened to the Lost Tribe, and it wasn't until 1607 that the British finally had a permanent colony in the Americas in a place called Jamestown.